Same thing. So that when I was done with the music, when it came out, that was when it clicked. Brad Charles and Gas and all you see, it's right. You get it. And literally that was that. And I would understand somebody would say, oh, you're lying, you're talking about, you know. But it's far from that.
It shouldn't be like that.
No, it's, so yeah, I'm just clearing it. Just for today. No wise. No wise. Yes.
Straight bullet.
Exactly. If you want to do let me listen and come back. Normally, they just when you lack it in a fabric. And when it's there, Angel can listen to some of the songs and really want me to take a line out. And as soon as that line comes out, and you mean me and him in the
interview.
Exactly. But it's never personal. And Brad Charles is far from my brother.
Okay. So the SM fans, you guys should know about this. Brad Charles is could even be Charles Dan because or a non-existent Charles. Exactly. I see. Now, do you also mean it when you said now? Maybe we can start. We are not going to play it in no particular order. We are going to listen to them. And I hope you've done the cleaning already.
Okay, well, I was about to say that. Honestly, I'm sorry. So when I record in the studio creatively, I think most artists would relate. You just want to say exactly what you want to say. Then afterwards, the technical bit is the engineer, the management, they go through beeping out or whatever that suits really. Yeah, so boss, I'm sorry, I gave you work, but you didn't have to like listen to, because even the producers, when I told them to do the clean version, they still weren't able to do 100. You're done. I trust you, boss. So my favorite, I think it keeps changing. I was definitely into No Fugazi, but I think I love anything. Yes, anything is that I like.
What is making it change? What made it move from No Fugazi to anything?
I think I've loved anything for a very long time because it was there before No Fugazi. So that fact that No Fugazi is new and it's fresh, I loved it. And then it was Afrobeat that I was rapping. I was really, really rapping. It sounds like hip hop, but then it's still Afrobeat. It's new for me, so I loved it. But anything is more of the message. The music and the mood of the beat is very, you know, it's very sack.
Now, is this album actually created for your hip hop lovers? Because I have seen some one or two comments, people who think that, this is for the sack or the hip hop class.
Yes, not all the way, because I can say it's hip hop dominated, but it's not like 100% hip hop.
Exactly.
My previous album, which was Black Love, was dominated by Afro. Naturally, as a creative person, you get tired of sound. So none of my albums were back to back the same thing. So when I get frustrated, I can go and do Mary and then come out. And it brings you back when you're back.
Did you say when you got frustrated?
The inspiration came from grammar. Then I get, I don't know how to explain it. Every creative person can tell you that. You can hit a block where you can't write anymore. And that means you're not challenging yourself. So then you have to switch and try something else. And then when you come back to rap, you appreciate it. Now that I've dropped this one, if I do a hip-hop album again, my approach will be hard, because now I'm about to do the same thing over again. But then if I go and try jazz and come back to this, then I'll appreciate it. So that's literally what I do.